what's up, guys? So, just want to make a quick little unboxing video of the mysterygrail.com. I guess these were like PSA graded, like gem mint 10s or something like that for Pokemon cards. I don't know anything about Pokemon cards, but I just want to take a gamble and stuff. So, this is what they come wrapped in, which I think is, I mean, come on, it's ridiculous. You know, if something's potentially, you know, really pricey, like gem mint card, like a grail for some, you know, why would it come in something like this thin paper packaging? So, I mean, that's my first complaint. So, well, I guess I see why. They come, first of all, this paper thing here, right? And then they come neatly wrapped, I guess, in these bubble protectors. So there's two of them. And let me just go ahead and, again, this is me unboxing, so I've never bought one of these before. I have no idea what to expect. Don't know what the values would be. So what I'll do is probably, I don't know, I'll have to like either add it to this video afterwards. But unless if it's a Pikachu or, I really don't know what to expect. Okay, so let's see. So this is, okay. I guess it's packaged well. So they come packaging these bubble mailers, and then within the bubble mailer, I get another cardboard. What, something just fell out of here. Okay, so I guess for their scratch and win, their new little game that they have. What else? There's, I'm trying not to look in here. Okay, so that's, the card is in my hand. Another, the original scratch and win and stuff. Okay, and this is a, I don't know if you guys can tell. What is this? Let's see. Maybe I should have turned on the light. Gem Mint. I can't even pronounce the name. Jesus. Not even going to try. Don't know what that's worth. So I'm going to have to make a separate video for that. Oh. Whatever, I have no idea what that is. Okay, so next one. Where did I, oh, here it is. Okay, and someone on the Gastlecast page, I think it was the homie Paul Rumsey, all the way from Australia, wanted to know what I was going to get. So this is really, shouts out to Paul, aka Dead Paul. All right, so. Alright, put that aside. So let's see. Again, wrapped very safely. It's a little scary though, that little wrap. The little mailer. Okay, so again, another one of these cards. Another one of these. And the card itself. Ooh. This is, what is this, Blastoise? Yeah, Blastoise, Gem Mint 10. I don't know how hard it is for you guys to see. Let's see, a little bit of reflection here. But Gem Mint 10, I have no idea what these are worth. Oh, this one's like a refractor. I don't know if you could tell. Man, I picked the worst lighting. All right, so let me just quickly pause the video, and what I'll do is I'll turn the light on. Oh boy, it's kind of hard to see, especially when your age is, when you're getting up there in age and your vision's going. All right, so give me a second, let me come right back. All right, so just a quick little look on Google, looking at pricecharting.com. So the first card I have is the Radiant Blastoise Pokemon Japanese Go number 18. This one, it seems to be trending at $26.99. So, whatever. Not that great of a card, I guess. All right. The next one, which I have no idea who this is. Zeraora V. Number 24 Pokemon Japanese Jet Black Spirit. PSA 10. This one is actually $61.10. So, if I remember correctly, both of them, the total was like $84 shipped or something. Let me see. I have the price right here. Let me see. No, $78 total for both. And then $6 shipping. So $86. 61 plus, let's see, 27. So that's at $88, $87. So pretty much broke even, as Franchise Kicks would say. But I guess, I don't know, for my first time ever trying one of these mystery grails. Cool. The only thing, this thing took forever to get here. Let me see. When did I place the order? And this is another one of my complaints. Ordered this on November 21st. And today is December 4th. So, pretty long time. Almost 3 weeks. 3 weeks almost. 2 weeks or so. A little bit over 2 weeks. But whatever. They're here. And I guess, whatever, for what it's worth. But at least I have two of my first Pokemon cards. So, anyways. So, I thought I'd share this with you guys just because some people, I guess, they like collecting these things. I like mystery boxes and stuff. It's not always a grand slam every time. So, anyways, guys. All right, I'll holler at you guys later. Peace.